A fighter jet is an advanced machine capable of flying at incredible speeds. One of the secrets behind that speed lies in its jet engine, which serves as the aircraft's main propulsion system. This engine works by expelling hot gases out the back through a part called the nozzle, creating powerful thrust that pushes the aircraft forward. When the afterburner is activated, you can even see bright flames shooting out from the nozzle. But have you ever wondered, what exactly is the nozzle made of? How can it withstand those extreme temperatures without melting? Well, in this video, we're going to break it all down for you. When we talk about modern fighter jets, most of them use a type of engine called a turbofan. Meanwhile, earlier generations of fighter jets typically used turbojet engines. Although they're different in design, both belong to the same family of gas turbine engines. And it's not just jet fighters that use gas turbines. Propeller-driven planes like the C-130 Hercules rely on turboprop engines, while helicopters use a type called turboshaft. In essence, they all work on the same basic principles. Generally, a gas turbine engine has three main sections. First, there's the compressor, which compresses the incoming air. Then, the combustion chamber, where fuel is burned at extremely high temperatures. And finally, the turbine, which extracts energy from the hot gases. Once the gases pass through the turbine, they exit through the nozzle at the back of the engine. Inside the combustion chamber, temperatures can reach around 1700 degrees Celsius. That's incredibly hot, especially when you consider that steel melts at about 1538 degrees Celsius. So, how come parts like the nozzle, which are made from metal, don't just melt away? The first reason is that the nozzle is actually positioned quite far from the combustion chamber. The hot gases produced by combustion don't go straight to the nozzle. They have to pass through several stages, including the turbine blades. By the time the gases reach the nozzle, their temperature has dropped significantly, usually to around 800 to 900 degrees Celsius. That's still extremely hot, but not enough to melt steel. But what about parts of the engine that are closer to the combustion zone, like the turbine blades and the walls of the combustion chamber? These components are exposed to much higher temperatures, temperatures that could easily melt metal. So why don't they glow red hot or melt? The answer lies in the advanced cooling systems built into jet engines. You see, the flames and hot gases never directly touch these components. Instead, a thin layer of air flows along their surfaces, shielding them from direct contact with extreme heat. This cooling air comes from the compressor. Not all the compressed air is sent into the combustion chamber for burning fuel. A significant portion is redirected to cool down the hot engine parts. For example, turbine blades are designed with tiny holes on their surfaces. Cooling air flows inside the blades and exits through these holes, creating a protective film of air over their surfaces. This prevents the hot combustion gases from directly contacting the metal. As a result, heat transfer only occurs through radiation, not direct conduction, greatly reducing the amount of heat absorbed by the metal. In addition to protecting these components, the airflow also helps carry excess heat away, keeping everything at a safe temperature. The same technique is applied to the combustion chamber walls and the interior of the nozzle. If you look closely at the nozzle area, you'll find lots of tiny holes. These allow cooling air from the compressor to flow out and form another protective barrier, ensuring the nozzle stays cool enough to survive even the hottest exhaust gases. So that's the secret behind why jet engine nozzles and other critical parts don't melt, even though they're constantly exposed to extreme temperatures. Pretty amazing, right? Jet engine technology is an incredible feat of engineering. If you enjoyed this explanation, don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and turn on notifications so you won't miss future videos. See you in the next one.